there and welcome to another demo by Image Maven. This demo is about the advantages of using masks over just straight selections when blending two images together. Alright, so I have in this file, I have two separate images. I have the image of the Citadel from Halifax and I have an image of the baby. What I'm planning to do is combine these images. So what I'm going to do is actually make a mask on the top layer which has the Citadel. So I'm going to click my mask tool. And I'm going to start painting with black, because black is the tool that you use to hide. So I'm going to hide the top layer. I'll make my brush a bit bigger. I'm going to hide the top layer. Okay, now as you see, I'm not being very careful. I'm going over the lines a bit. So what do? I can actually paint back with white. So I'm going to change my brushes. I'm just going to show you where I'm doing that. I'm doing that in this corner. I'm going to change the foreground color to white. And I'm going to start painting with white so I can actually paint back my mistakes. There we go. Now, another way to do this, of course, is to actually make a selection using another type of selection tool. My favorite is the magnetic lasso tool. We'll start from scratch. I'll choose my magnetic lasso tool, and now I'm going to start making my selection. And the great thing about the magnetic lasso tool is it kind of sticks to the edge where the contrast changes or the color will change. So I find it's really handy in making a quick selection that's kind of complicated. And you just drag and you click every once in a while, and you drag and you click. It'll even go around corners, which is great. Alrighty. And then of course with any kind of selection tool, especially if you're drawing any kind of an open-ended selection, you always have to complete the circle or the square. You have to go back to the start point or it won't work. So now I have a selection, and what do you think I'm going to do? I'm going to add a layer mask. Whoops, went the wrong way around. Okay, let's undo that, because what I've done is I've masked the background of the Citadel, and I've left sort of like a piece of bread shaped shape left over. So I actually want the opposite to happen. So I'm going to Command Z, and I'm going to hold down the Option key, or the Alt key if you're on a PC, and add a layer mask that's going to be the opposite. So now it's a black layer mask where the baby is. So now I have the baby peeking out of the Citadel. Now again, you can touch this up again using the brush tools. Whoops, wrong one. Switch them around, and you can paint back using black, because remember, black hides. So I want to hide a little bit more of the Citadel. I want to refine my edge just a little bit there. All right, that's it for the demo. Thanks again.